Hello, and welcome to our video.
Almost everyone has tried balancing a broomstick or pole on the end of their finger. As a human, this problem of balancing is fairly easy. We move our hands to keep the pole from falling over. In physics, the system is called an inverted pendulum. While it may be simple from our point of view, there is actually a large amount of physics and math that goes into balancing systems like this, and it turns out that a lot of modern technology, including segways, rockets, and self-balancing unicycles, are versions of inverted pendulums. While this is a problem that has been solved before, we thought that this was an interesting and decided to investigate these inverted pendulums for our final project. We decided that it would be interesting to try and combine the two ideas of a motor and a cart to create our very own inverted pendulum. For our project, we decided that our pendulum wouldn't just sit on a cart, it would be the cart. To achieve this, we decided to make the body of the robot long and skinny and mount it onto the robot's wheels. This required the robot to employ active control to remain upright. After looking around for some possible robots, we found the Babloa Balancing Robot Kit from Palulu, a kit that was meant to be a robot that, in itself, was an inverted pendulum.
Our free body diagram for our inverted pendulum. As you can see, there's a force of gravity from the center of mass, and then the force of the motor to balance out the actual pendulum. This is our theta, and this is our radius from the center of the motor to the center of gravity.
Before we could analyze our controller, we had to decide what kind of controller to go with. For our system, we wanted a controller that could produce a minimum steady state error that is easily converged to fully target value, not lingering outside of the range that would allow the robot to stay relatively stationary. Thus, we cared less about overshoot and only slightly about rise time. We decided to go with a PI controller because it fit best with the scope of our project.
In order to create a PI controller, you need to have some form of feedback, which in our case was the actual position subtracted from our target position, or of upright or balanced. From there, the error signal goes into the PI controller. Here you can see the constants KP and KI that actually form the feedback part of the controller. In order to fully control our system, however, we also needed to have a control loop that dealt with the velocities of the motors. This control loop is something that we found after looking up documentation on the motors and allows us to fully control their position and velocity. After the motor controller transfer function, we have a block which is the plant of our system, which we solve for using basic free body diagram analysis. From there, we integrated these controller blocks into a full feedback controller, took the transfer function of that controller, and then set our poles equal to the values that we wanted them to be. From there, we could then solve for the coefficients of control and plug those into our real system.
Once we derived our equations of motion, transfer function, coefficients, and control equations, all that was left was the physical implementation of the real system. The bulk of the work was modifying base Arduino code for our robot using our controls and equations. The board we got came with a lot of libraries for using, controlling, and reading sensor data, so most of our work was in actually implementing the controls. Of course, code doesn't always work as planned due to many kinds of error. After writing, rewriting, and debugging, we were able to successfully implement working code that took into account our specific parameters. The response of the robot was quite abrupt, with it never varying past 10 degrees from upright despite heavy perturbations. This validates our control and shows that we were successfully able to create a stable system. Going further, notice the oscillation after it being nudged. The bot overshoots then come back, as our pole selection would imply. Beyond that, the period of these oscillations following the perturbation are all nearly exactly 1 second, just as intended. The initial wiggle at the beginning of the plot is a result of the startup sequence, which requires the robot falling to at least 3 degrees before the control begins. One of the most obvious limitations of our project is that control is slightly imperfect. The robot sometimes twists when it is perpetuated and oscillates back and forth slightly, even when it's not touched. Additionally, our robot does not include position control. Implementing this would make our robot balancing significantly better. Another limitation of our robot is that we never reset our integral components for velocity. This causes the robot to behave extremely erratically after it has been lifted from the ground, held in place, or being disrupted by large angles.